Hello, it's really lovely to be talking to you again and sharing with you. Sending my love to you here from Lincoln. We are living in very interesting and strange, challenging times, aren't we? I guess in years to come, this will be known as the year of COVID-19. And maybe some of our younger people will be talking like older people do, say, do you remember the year of COVID? And I guess for so many of us, it's been a huge challenge. It's been a time of disappointment. My wife and I had our 50th wedding anniversary, and we were all geared up for a great celebration. And, well, it had to be postponed. Our travel plans had to be literally put on hold indefinitely. And I guess so many of us are finding there are things postponed, changed, just abandoned and given up on. Things that we had hoped for and desired. This is the year of COVID. And COVID seems to have been like the shadow across all of our lives. It's been a year not only of the challenge of COVID, but some of us have had years of challenge within the challenge of loneliness, and maybe some suffering with sickness and illness. I'm just recovering from 7 weeks, recovering from a fall. I just don't bounce like I used to, and I went for this flying leap and ended up really damaging my legs and my arm, and the pain has been agonizing. And in the year of COVID, other things in life kick in as well, don't they? And things personally, things in our families. Gosh, we have to carry so many things. And I wonder how many of you have found that in this time you've kind of kept going back to a Bible verse. I've heard so many people say, every day I say, the Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. Psalm 23. I've heard other people saying, the Lord is my light and my salvation, whom shall I fear? What shall I fear? Because this is a time when fear seems to come to the surface in society and in our lives. And maybe, Lord, you are my shield. You're a shield about me. You're my glory. You're the lifter of my head. I like that, because we've been shielding, but I'm thankful that though we are shielding, we have a shield also around us. For me, it's the scripture by a prophet in the Old Testament, centuries before Jesus came. He was called a messianic prophet because he foretold the things of Christ. He foretold his suffering, and he foretold the things that he would do through his death on the cross. Isaiah. And Isaiah chapter 6 has been a foundational scripture in my life. You might have heard me talk about it before. And Isaiah 6 begins with these words, in the year that King Uzziah died. In the same way as perhaps we in the future will say, in the year of COVID. For Isaiah, the year that King Uzziah died, I wonder what the emotions were he was going through. You may not have heard of Uzziah, you've heard of Isaiah, but Uzziah was a king, and he was a king who started well. I'd like to say for all of us in whatever area of our lives, especially spiritually, starting well is important, but finishing well is more important. And Uzziah started very well. The Bible said he was a king that did everything that was right in God's eyes. Oh my goodness. If only we had leaders in our nations that did what was right in God's eyes. And Uzziah was an incredibly talented man. He was one of these guys who, I'm sure you've met them, that whatever they turn their hand to, they are brilliant. They can do it. He was a craftsman. He was a designer. He was a technician. He was a builder. He was an incredible military man. Everything that he touched, he was perfect. He was creative as well as artistic. He was a technician. Gosh, I wish I was like that. I have a few things that I can do quite well, but there's so many things I can't do. I'm the one who lifts the bonnet of the car. And they say, could you show me where the dipstick is? And I say, yes, I'm standing here. I'm useless. I can put paint upside down. I'm the one, when I put a shelf up, my wife says, is it meant to be like that? But hey, we have our skills, we have our abilities. But Uzziah was one of those guys that, hey, he could do almost anything, but that was his strength, but it was also his weakness. And one day, he wanted to overstep his calling. He wanted to go beyond what he was meant to be. He decided one day, I'm going to be a priest. Now, a priest actually wasn't something that you decided to be. It was something that God called you to. But he decided he was going to be a priest. And he was going to go into the sanctuary, into the holy place, and do all the priestly things that they had to do. And God says, not a good idea, Uzziah. This is going beyond your calling. But the man who started well didn't finish well, because he ended up being a priest, but going into the holy place and finding that he was touching things that God hadn't called him to get involved with. Sadly, he ended up with leprosy. Sadly, so sadly, he ended up living with the lepers outside of the palace, looking through the gates into where he should be dwelling, living outside of his purpose. Well, there's a preach for another day. But in the year that King Uzziah died, I wonder what was going through Isaiah's mind. I guess there was disappointment. I guess there was incredible sense of loss for himself, for the nation. It was a tragedy. It was a case of what could have been, what should have been, what might have been. In the year of King Uzziah died. And I so feel it's a little bit like in the year of COVID. How many of us have had could have beens, might have beens, should have beens. Things that actually no longer have happened. Things that have passed us by. Things that have been cancelled, postponed, abandoned. In the year that King Uzziah died. So how did you feel, Isaiah? Now, actually, that isn't the question that was asked. Because at times like this, significant times like this, it's not about how you feel. Because we all feel things, but our feelings are never to be trusted. Our feelings are up and down like barometers. We can never put our foundations on feelings. We are people who know. Our confidence is in the Lord, the maker of heaven and earth. It's not a feeling. It's a confidence. It's a faith. So the question wasn't, how do you feel in the year of COVID? How do you feel, Isaiah, in the year the King Uzziah died? The question is, what are you seeing? What is becoming very apparent to you in this time? For Isaiah, It says in Isaiah 6, he said, in the year the king Uzziah died, I saw also the Lord. My friends, it's so important in times of challenge what you also see. Because what we see is what determines where we move to and what we do. What we see establishes our steps. And in the year the king Uzziah died, he said, I saw also the Lord. What did you see about the Lord, Isaiah? He said, he was sitting on his throne. But surely at a time of incredible pain and hardship, God should be rushing around doing all kinds of things to put things right, to fix it. No. God was sitting on his throne. And I want to say today, beloved, that God isn't panicked by COVID. God isn't rushing around the earth saying, my goodness, this is getting out of hand. I don't know where this is going. This is really contravening my omniscience and my omnipotence. This is getting out of hand. No. God is still on the throne. And today I want to make that statement. What do you see in this time? And I want to point you to the fact, see the Lord. See also the Lord. See him sitting on his throne. See him ruling. God has not abandoned his place of authority. Isaiah, what else happened? He said, I heard the angels calling to one another around the throne, isn't our God holy? Holy, holy. And the God that is sitting on the throne is a thrice holy God. And today holiness is in the place of authority. And he's asking us to see him. Because what we look at is what we will become. And the words coming down through the ages says, be holy, even as I am holy. There's a call to the church today, more than ever, be holy. I'm aware there's a scripture which says in the time of Noah, in the days of Noah. You know the story of Noah. It's a great story. It's taught amongst children in our children's classes. And Noah built an ark. And all the animals were collected and the rain came down and the flood came up and Noah sailed into the sunset. But the bottom line of this story is judgment was coming and it wasn't the ark that saved him. It was his righteousness. He was righteous before God. God looked for a man who would be obedient to his voice. And I have a feeling that today God is looking for people who look at a holy God and desire that righteousness of life too. And will be obedient to what he says, whatever he says to you, to do it. Even in these challenging times, to be obedient to the God who knows. And the God who understands. And the God who is able. In fact, he's more than able. In the year the king Uzziah died, I saw also the Lord. I heard the cry that our God, isn't he holy? And I heard God say, as he revealed to Isaiah the sinfulness of society at that time, and God was looking for someone who would tell the message of what he had seen and heard. Remember that. When we reach out to the not yet Christians, we tell them what we have seen and heard. And he heard God say, yes, you see the society, you see the world, but who will go for us? The triune God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit was saying, who will go for us to tell them that I am still on the throne? I haven't abandoned you. I have not rejected you. And Isaiah said, here I am. Send me. I'm reminded of a time in my teenage years when I sat on the steps of a church in Ealing, having messed up my life hugely in all kinds of ways. Another day, another story. But I remember crying out to God. I said, God, if you can do anything with a messed up life like mine, here I am. All my plans, all my decisions, all my ideas were outside of God's heart and will. But on those steps, I said, God, if you can do anything with a messed up life like mine, here I am. I kind of think God said, in the absence of too many volunteers, Chris, yes, you'll do. I believe that God is looking for those who will go. If I'm asked one question about this time of COVID, what is the story behind it? A friend of mine, Tony Miller, said recently that COVID is not the message, it's the context. But in it, there's a message. And I believe the message is mission. I believe the message is reaching out. I believe the message that God is presenting to us as a church as never before is that all kinds of other things are having to be put slightly aside at the moment. All the things that you hold on to, all the things that you want, all the things that you miss are put aside for this one purpose, mission. To reach out, to go out. And I encourage you, church, to turn this season not into a time of self-pity, but into a time of God's purposes being fulfilled in the earth, such as you have seen and such as you have heard. Go. Go to the neighbours, go to the family, go to the town, go to the nation, go to the earth. In all kinds of ways in this internet generation, we can go as never before. Because the call today is mission. In the year that King Uzziah died, Uzziah was dead, but God was alive. Go. Tell the people that our God reigns. And those of you watching and listening who are not yet Christians, who are searching, seeking, longing, desiring, going through all the same issues that we are, and yet without the faith, I encourage you, in this time where you see so much going on that confuses and disappoints, in a broken society, see also the Lord. God bless you. May he surround you with his peace. May he fill you with his love. May he keep you in his presence. And may we all declare that this is the time to say, here I am. Send me. God bless you.